Hi everybody, in this video I will explain how to estimate the liquefaction potential of sand using field data from standard penetration test, and we're going to use a procedure proposed by Seed and his colleagues. So in this case we'll estimate a cyclic stress ratio, and then we're going to look at this chart and see if the soil, in particular sand, is liquefiable or not. So let's look at this example that is written here. So let's say that we have a clean sand, which means that we have fines less than 5%, in this case less than 3%, at a depth of 4 meters. And when the SPT test was performed and correlated to the energy of hammer and to the orbital pressure, this N160 was 12. Also during that investigation, it was found that the groundwater level was 1 meter below the ground surface, so it was pretty high. And let's estimate the liquefaction potential of this sand in case if there is an earthquake with magnitude of 7, and the epicenter will be about 25 kilometers away from the investigation site. And also we should consider soft conditions at the site, and I will explain why we need this one. Okay, so to do that, we're going to use this procedure to calculate cyclic stress ratio. You will see that what we need to know is peak acceleration at the surface, and we need to know the effective vertical stress, here this one, and the total stress as well. And there is this coefficient, it's called stress reduction coefficient. We can roughly estimate it using these two empirical formulas. So this one for the depth less than 9.15 meters, and this one will be for the depth that is greater than 9.15 meters, but less than 23 meters. So you will see that in our case, the depth is 4 meters. This means that we're going to use this value of stress reduction coefficient. Okay, now let's find it. I'm going to write it down here. So this coefficient will be equal 1 minus 0.00765 times 4 meters. So that will give us approximately 0.969. Okay, so we found this. Now we're going to find the maximum or peak acceleration at the surface. To do that, we're going to look at these two charts proposed by Idris in his work in 1991. So this one is for soft site conditions, and this one is for, what's it called, rock site conditions. So in our case we have soft soil conditions, so we're going to use this chart. So in this case we're going to look at the distance to the epicenter, and in our case it's 25 kilometers here, and magnitude is 7, so it will be about here. So you will see that this point, that will be about 0.3 g. So we're going to write that maximum acceleration that can be expected is 0.3 g. Next step is total vertical stress. So to find total vertical stress, we need to find the unit weight and multiply it by the depth. So we don't know the unit weight of the sand, it's not given. So we'll assume that common unit weight is 18 kilonewton per square meters. 18 times 4 will give us 72 kPa. So now we need to find pore water pressure. Pore water pressure, it says that it's 1 meter below the ground, and we have 4 meters to the sand of interest. So in this case, it will be 4 minus 1 meters times the unit weight of water, 9.81. So that will give us 29.43 kPa. And now let's find the vertical effective stress. So it will be total stress minus pore to pressure, 72 minus 29.43. That will give us approximately 42.6 kPa. Okay, so now we're going to estimate cyclic stress ratio. I'm going to erase this one and write here. So we're going to write now that cyclic stress ratio. Cyclic stress ratio. It's 0.65 times the peak acceleration, which we really decide is going to be 0.3 g divided by g. So in this case, same thing. Then multiply by the total vertical stress, which is 72, divided by effective vertical stress, 42.6, and times the stress reduction coefficient, which is 0.969. So according to my calculations, we're gonna get about 0.319. So this is the value. So now let's look at this chart, and here it says cyclic stress ratio. We're gonna find our value. It's about 0.32. It's here, and it's actually pretty high. And we're gonna look at the N160, which is 12. It's somewhere here. So we have a point here. Okay, so the way we look at this chart, you see there's a few lines here. It depends on the percentage of fines. This one is for the clean sand with percentage less than 5. So the way we see it, everything in this area is going to liquefy, liquefaction. Everything here, there is no liquefaction. So according to our estimates, we have a point in the area where it's supposed to liquefy. So we can say that if there is such an earthquake with a magnitude of 7 and the epicenter about 25 kilometers from the site, this particular sand will have a high chance to liquefy. Well, that's how we use cyclic stress ratio to estimate the liquefaction potential of sand. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.